Hello students, in this video we are going to study about disaster and the types of disaster and what is disaster management. Okay, so this is the lesson from lesson number 9, disaster management for 11th standard science and arts students for geography subject. So before understanding disaster management, we must know what is disaster and how it occurs. Basically, disaster can be natural, it can be man-made. Okay, so there are any type of process by which a disaster can happen. It can be a natural, it can be a man-made. So some disaster can be prevented before it happens, or there can be some impact, less impact after those occurrences. Generally, man-made disasters can be prevented as they happen during the mistakes or carelessness by humans. So basically, if we are aware that what are the consequences of certain activities, if such activities are prevented before a disaster occurs, then you can avoid the disaster to take place. Disasters affect human population, while some ever may occur only in nature. So basically, some they have a natural aspect and some are having a background of human. So both of the things are included in the case of disaster. For example, volcanic eruption is the natural process which cannot be prevented. Such events are called as hazards. When they occur in areas inhabited by humans and cause damage, they are termed as disaster. So basically, we know that there are some natural calamities which occurs, which are not in the hand of humans. Okay, they occur naturally, like earthquake, volcano, cyclones. Okay, so such type of disaster, when these disasters they damage the humans or they damage the human settlements, then we call it as disaster. And if they don't damage the human settlements, then we call it as hazard. Okay, so there is a difference between disaster and hazard. So basically, when there is a loss of human or the settlements of human, then we call it as a disaster. And if there is less loss of human or no loss of human, it occurs on some empty place, then we call it as hazard. A disaster is certain, sudden, calamitous event that seriously disrupts the functions of community or society and cause human, material and economic or environmental losses that exceed the community or a society ability to cope using its own resources. Though often caused by nature, disasters can have human origins. So even though if some of the disasters they occur naturally, still the background or indirectly they may have a human origin or base, because of large amount of population, we can see nowadays that there is an imbalance in ecosystem. So when there is an imbalance in the ecosystem, then what happens? Certainly we are indirectly affecting the environment, and because of those changes, you can see that there are some floods, tsunami waves, okay, because of any time it rains. So all these things are because of human interventions in the natural process. So even though if you feel that some disasters are natural, but they may have a background of human or an human origin. So vulnerability plus hazard, which will be divided by capacity, will give you a disaster. So vulnerability means some areas which are highly susceptible to some of the natural disasters, like some places are very much active for volcanoes, some places are very much active for earthquake, some are very much active for drought. So these are the vulnerable places for that particular occurrence. Then hazard means what? Hazard is nothing but it is an type of loss or it is a type of damage of some particular area. So these are the things, by this formula you can calculate the disaster. A disaster occurs when a hazard impacts on vulnerable people. The combination of hazards, vulnerability and inability to reduce the potential negative consequences of risk results into a disaster. Now let us see what is disaster management. So this lesson itself is about disaster management. How can we prevent the consequences of disaster? So disaster management refers to the conservation of lives and property during natural and man-made disaster. So what is disaster management? It is just a process that when the disaster occurs, whether the disaster is natural or man-made, how to save the living things like humans and how to save the properties, that is the work of disaster management. Okay, it tries to bring everything to the normal stage. So disaster management is nothing but it is just a team of people who try to rescue the peoples or the victims of disaster. Okay, so they refer to the conservation of lives and properties during the natural and man-made disaster. Disaster management plans are multi-layered and are planned to address issues such as flood, hurricanes, fires, mass failures of utilities, rapid spread of disease and droughts. Disaster management can be defined as the organization and management of resources and responsibilities for dealing with humanitarian aspects of emergencies, in particular preparedness, response, recovery, in order to lessen the impact of disaster. So basically, because of disaster management, you can just manage the resources and you can save the resources with the help of preparedness, response and the recovery. Now these are all the aspects of disaster management cycle. Okay. So this cycle works in the same way or in the same sequence, just as to recover all the things back to the normal stage as it was earlier. So this is the work of disaster management, to rescue the people and the properties. Now next, we are going to see some of the types of disasters. So the disasters are basically classified into the types based on its origins. So the first is tectonic, then geological, biological, anthropogenic and meteorological. Let us study them one by one. So the tectonic disaster, we all are aware of tectonic plates. We know that earthquake occur because of tectonic plates. So these are the disasters that occurs due to the tectonic activities of the continental plates, which manifest themselves in earthquakes and volcanic eruption. So we all know that because of there is a continuous movement of the tectonic plates, and because of that there are two natural disasters which occur, those are earthquake and volcano. A tectonic event is a physical occurrence resulting from the movement of earth crust. They are predominant earthquakes and volcanic eruptions. A tectonic hazard is when they have the potential to cause the loss of life and damage of property. An earthquake is a perceptible vibration of surface of the earth. So basically, the examples of tectonic disasters are earthquake, then volcanic eruption. If the earthquake occurs inside the ocean floor, it is definitely going to origin the tsunami waves. Even if volcano is going to erupt, it may also cause tsunami waves. So all these are the examples of tectonic disaster. So one of the live example is the great tsunami and the earthquake of Indonesia occurred on 26 December 2004. So there was an earthquake which occurred in Indonesia, and because of that earthquake there was a very huge vibration which caused the tsunami, and that had affected India's coastline too. Now the next disaster is geological disaster. So the geological disaster occurs when natural geological process impact in our activities, either through loss of injury or life or through economic loss. So basically this is a hazard which has a potential to disaster. Now there are some disaster which occurs on some places and which causes the loss of life and loss of properties. Okay, you can see here, this is an example of landslide, or you can see mudslides. Okay, so here you can see that there is a loss of life, there is a loss of injuries, injured people will be more. You can see there is an economic loss, there is a loss of settlements, okay, property loss. So such type of disasters are called as geological disaster. So the examples are landslide, mudslide, avalanches. The Malin mudslide of 2014 in Maharashtra is an example of geological disaster. Next is meteorological disaster. Now meteorological disaster are caused by extreme weather. So basically, if there is an extreme weather, very cold, very hot, very snowy, such type of weathers which are very much extreme, which are unbearable, they are called as meteorological disasters. So violent and sudden destructive to the environment related to produced by or affecting the earth's atmosphere, especially the weather forming processes. So the examples are floods, cyclones, storm, heat waves, etc. The flood of Kerala of 2018 is the live example of meteorological disaster which took place in India. So you can see here there is a thunderstorm, there is a flash of water. Okay, so you can see here there are n numbers of examples which has taken place because of extreme climate like drought, rain, snowfall, extremely hot, extreme wind. So all these things, they come under meteorological disaster. Next is biological disaster. Now basically biological disasters are occurred because of living organism. So there are some of the living organisms which causes some of the enormous spread, okay, of diseases. They cause a disease, or they release some viruses in the atmosphere and which just spread within a shorter period of time, and it affects a lot of people. So such type of disasters are called as biological disaster. Biological disaster can also be simply a sudden growth in population of a certain kind of plants or animals. Example, locust plague. So there can be a sudden growth in the population of some kind of plants or animals. That can also be called as biological disaster. Examples are locust acts, pest attacks, epidemics such as flus, dengues, cholera. So these are all the examples of biological disaster. So the live example of India is the Surat plague, which was occurred in Surat in India in 1992. So plague is basically a disease which is caused because of rat. Okay, now these are the flies which drink the rat's blood, and these flies, they come and bite the human. Okay, so such type of viruses can spread, and they can be transmitted from one living organism to another living organism. Next is anthropogenic man-made disaster. So anthropogenic are the disasters which are made by man because of the activities of man. Human action or inaction, they are the contrast with natural hazards. Anthropogenic hazards may adversely affect by human, other organisms, biomes and ecosystem. So because of man-made disaster, there is an impact in ecosystem, there is an impact in the environment, in the biomes. The frequency and severity of hazards are the key elements in some risk analysis methodology. So the examples are industrial accidents, transportation accidents, nuclear accidents, and Bhopal gas tragedy is a live example of India in 1984. In the image you can see the trees in the jungle have been burned, and the pollution because of industries has been released. So these types of activities are called as anthropogenic disasters. So this is all about disasters, the type of disasters, what is disasters management that we have studied. The remaining part will be discussed in the next video. Keep watching the videos. If any query, you can just comment me in the comment section. Thank you all.